What if a computer could create new recipes as a cook? What if a smartphone could answer legal questions? This is not just sci-fi anymore. It's already happening. Let's have an example. On the one hand, you have the Parisian tube that stops at every station because it was programmed to do it. On the other hand, you have the Google car that stops at every red light, thanks God, not because it was programmed to do it, because it understands what a red light is, and it observes other drivers and processes internet information. And this is artificial intelligence. So the idea is to have a system that understands its environment and asks itself the right questions to make the relevant decisions. For instance, the system can understand a language, but the cooler thing is that it can also manipulate concepts. Of course, it's not going to write a thesis in one night, but still, you remember the computer revolution was a big shift. Smartphone revolution, also big shift. The internet revolution, tremendous shift. But artificial intelligence, major shift. AI allows billions, trillions of possibilities. And you want to know why it matters for the banking industry? We are getting to that in the next video. But let's wrap up what I mean by artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is three components: data, computer power, and brain understanding. Data. Artificial intelligence learns by observing data, almost like a student with the passion of learning new knowledge. The more data it can observe, the smarter it becomes. Computer power. You need a lot of computing power to process this data, almost like the brain. And brain understanding. You need to understand how our brain works to be able to design working AI systems. And today, thanks to the cognitive sciences that are booming, we have it. Data, computer power, brain understanding, it's all what it takes to do AI. And we have it all at BNP Paribas. That's all for today. See you in our next video.